Welcome all of you and good evening. Welcome to the CAT 21 workshop. And today workshop is going to become one of the interesting and other point of view, you can say your preparation point of view also, it will be one of the milestone for understanding the verbal ability and vocabulary, because that is one of the challenging area. Millions of vocabulary are there. How to understand? We have very limited technique to make your very strong vocabulary. Very limited technique. One technique is there, you have to keep on read. That is, again, it will become a random collection of your vocabulary that may or may not be useful whenever it will be needed. But that must be, reading must be, because that is add-on point. But to make vocabulary very systematic or very conceptual, some kind of, you can say, logical flow or some kind of logic we should apply to understand this. Then whatever you will learn during your reading, it may be helpful. It will be helpful. Then today workshop, I am going to discuss about some historical background about the languages and how we can understand languages in better way. Mainly we are going to understand not all languages. Mainly we will focus on English language. But to understand the English language, we must know little bit about the history of the other languages, how it has come from the root and these all. You can say all input will may not possible in one workshop, but I will try to justify how best I can give you the ignition point to build your good vocabulary. And afterwards we'll come to the practice of impromptu speaking, and next will be your phase 1 preparation status, then CAT 21 premium. Before starting the session, just I want to ask you a few questions. This question may be puzzling, and many of the people, many intellectuals, philosophers try to think about all these questions, but very difficult to answer. On your screen, question is, what would we before God? Like everything, we are starting with God. God is like a nodal point. Anything happen beyond our human capacity, we will just push on God. But before God, how God itself created, afterwards God has created the universe. It is some natural process, or it is some cyclic timely process. What is there? The creation of God in different format. Whatever we believe or whatever mythologically acceptable in our society, it is very difficult to give answer. Any concrete answer we will not get. Next question, what is God? You ask any of the person, big person, or maybe any of the intellectuals, philosophers, scientists, it is very difficult to give answer what is God. Next question is, how God had been created this universe? Means which type of tool or technology God had used to create this universe, because this is so vast, so robust, and so time bounded. What I told, so vast, so robust, so time bounded. Nothing is failing. Never you will feel sunrise is happening after 1 hour. Whatever stipulated time is there, exactly same time. Sunset is happening, okay, आज थोड़ा सा छुट्टी है, एक घंटे लेट सनसेट होगा. नेवर, इट इज परफेक्ट टाइम बाउंडेड. एंड हाउ गॉड हैड क्रिएटेड दिस यूनिवर्स, दिस वुड बी अ लॉन्ग प्रोसेस. इट कुड नॉट बी अ वन टाइम प्रोसेस और सिंगल प्रोसेस. समथिंग यूनिवर्स हैज क्रिएटेड, इट कुड बी अ लॉन्ग प्रोसेस. वॉट प्रोसेस कुड बी देयर टू मेक दिस यूनिवर्स सो रोबस्ट, सो कॉम्प्लिकेटेड, स्टिल सो टाइमली बाउंडेड? This type of question, whenever you are getting free time, you can keep as your mind food. You think all these questions. This will give you a lot of intellectual idea how to understand about this world, how to understand about the universe, and how to think any topic very properly. What is beyond God? We don't know. Most of the time, we will get the answer, we don't know. What is beyond Shiva? We don't know. What was before Shiva? We don't know. What will happen after death? Mystery. More than 80% people are not believing in reincarnation. Means after death, again your birth will happen. 80% people on this earth, they are not believing. Hindu people are believing after death, again you will take the birth based on your whatever things you have not completed in this world, you will take again birth to complete that. Means whatever wish or whatever dream you have not fulfilled, you will come back again to this earth to fulfill that. This is again mythology. We don't know concrete answer. We can't give like a mathematics or quant, this will be answer 25. Or after death, this will happen, option D. It is all discussion point and thinking point for every person, every human being. If you want to develop your brain in multiple direction, you must think whenever, like this type of question, which are having open end, multiple dimension of thinking. What is beyond our universe? Beyond Earth itself, great difficulty. To know about Earth itself, a great difficulty. Beyond our universe, I am not telling beyond Earth. Beyond Earth, maybe we know about the Moon, we know about the Mars, we know about the Sun, or we know about something about the solar system. Not much, very less. Whatever we know or whatever our scientific community knows, either scientific development or technical development, or maybe through philosophy or religion, that is, you can say, very tiny part of real knowledge. What at before birth? All questions are puzzling. No concrete answer. None of the above. If we will give 1000 choice also, still it will be none of the above. Now, just we'll move forward. Why I am telling all these things? I am telling all these things to conceptualize, to understand the language and vocabulary. You will realize why all these are important in next 10 to 15 minutes. Most of the questions, whatever I shown to the screen, if you will ask various type of people from various stream or various subject or expertness, answer can be two type. Either nothing or we don't know. How God had created universe? We don't know. Before God, nothing was there. Or if nothing was there, or we don't know. Mostly we will land up either we are going through all these logic, scientific fact, or maybe reasoning, but finally we will land up in these two answers. Either nothing or we don't know. Means our journey is starting with we don't know. And after death also we don't know. Means full life and this universe is between we don't know. And actually nothing we know about. Whatever we know, it is very tiny. We start from nothing. Or we don't know. If any time you are feeling or anybody feeling I know too much, we should think about this question. Then we will realize we don't know or nothing we know. Whatever we know, that is just information that also may be correct or not correct. Because many of the scientific facts are challenged after a few years. Whatever we believed 20 years before, now it is challenged. That fact may not be correct. We don't know. Just move forward means basically we are starting with nothing. And Hindu philosophy, this nothing is called Shiva. I am telling very conceptual idea. If you will ask so many Mahatma and religious person also, what is Shiva? It is very difficult to define. This nothing is only Shiva. And this Shiva only will break in two parts, conscious mind and subconscious mind. And Shiva is a universal unconscious mind. Due to conscious mind, subconscious mind, these two will come in the human. Mainly we are using conscious mind in the form of science, reasoning, logic. Subconscious mind, who are very expert in any field, they will use. It is difficult to use, but if we are able to use 1 or 2% also of subconscious mind, that will be sufficient. But finally, this subconscious mind is a part of universal unconscious mind, that is Shiva. Due to we are telling, in every human being, part of God is there. Reason behind this. Or we can say every human is a God-like. It is a part of God. Okay, I will not go in this philosophical discussion. We'll move forward. From nothing, only we have the pinpoint for understanding this universe is Big Bang theory. This theory itself is challenged. How you can understand this vastness of subject and vastness of the vocabulary related to this universal development. Big Bang itself is challenged. One section of the scientists, they are telling it is not Big Bang, it is a collision of two universe. And based on the collision of two universe, third universe is created. Now both are having the question mark. If Big Bang is telling one single point, it is started everything. Like atom, this point was like one atom, and from one atom everything is created. This vast universe, that much matter, that much energy, that itself challenge. That much matter or energy, how can be concentrated in one point? or atomic particle? Difficult to decide. We don't know. Or another theory is collision of two universe. Then question will come, from where these two universes come? First two universe was there, it had collided, and after collision our universe, whatever we are living in this solar system, that is created. The question is, these two universe, how it was created, when it was created, who has created? Both of the things will be challenged. I am just taking you to understand the vocabulary in very holistic way. You will never get confusion in full life. After maybe this workshop only, you will never get confusion how to build vocabulary in better way. Nothing to universe, then again question is coming, who has created? God. Nothing to God, God to universe. Means if we know or we hypothesize from nothing universe is created, then question will come, who has created? Then we are giving answer, some Mila Jula answer, God, because we don't know. Wherever we don't know, we'll just throw on the God. It is like a dustbin. Whatever beyond our brain capacity, God knows. That is one kind of proverb we are using. God knows. Then God has created this universe, then God must come between nothing and universe creation. Means nothing to God, God to universe creation. Or this is your Big Bang theory. This is one small particle, dimension you can see. 3×10⁻²⁵ centimeter. If you are not a mathematics student also, then you can understand how much tiny it will be. We can't put a point also. This point also will be bigger than this dimension. And from here, all visible universe, what is dimension here? 3×10⁷ centimeter visible universe today. Whatever visible universe. Beyond that again, we don't know. This is called Big Bang theory. Another concept is there. This only limited region Big Bang happened. Although I don't know why this word they are using, bang. Bang means huge sound. Means explosion, huge explosion. If nothing was there, space was not there, medium was not there, then how we can say it was explosion? Who has listened this? And how anything, any person, maybe just suppose if somebody would be there, maybe God, how he would be listen if medium was not there? Due to this name itself is challenging, how people are telling or scientists are telling Big Bang. But only imagination based on the hypothesis, it was a big explosion, they are telling Big Bang. Just we'll move forward, little more patience needed from your side. You are thinking, sir is teaching philosophy. No, I will come to the vocabulary. And after all these understanding, you will feel, now understanding the vocabulary is easy. Collision of the two universe, this is another theory what scientific community are believing. Question is, how these two universe came? Who has created? Who and when? Again, answer is ultimate answer, God. This is your Big Bang. This small point has exploded in all the direction. Everybody, if you will ask, they will tell reason of the creation of universe is a Big Bang. But how Big Bang happened? Or before Big Bang? We don't know. We have very limited scope of understanding. Very limited scope of understanding. And hardly we are using 1 or 2% of our brain capacity. Hardly. That much unlimited capacity we have. Rare of the rarest people are using, who are able to connect their conscious mind to the subconscious mind. It is like osmosis process. If you are a biology student, or if you are not a biology student, little bit chemistry you know, then conscious to subconscious, it will be osmosis process. This is a spongy type. And this is your collision of two universe. Then third universe has come. From where this has come? From where this has come? If this was there, then maybe beyond this two universe, another universe would be there. If another universe would be there, means how to count and how to guess or how to hypothesize the initial point of creation. These are a lifelong thinking. Millions of people has thought, but we are not getting concrete answer. Now, means we can say in lump sum, we are not going to now that point before God or these all. Just we want to summarize now. If God was there or not there, but we are believing God is there. He has created the universe. What consists in this universe? Space and matter. Space is there and matter is there. how much space, how much matter? One golden universal rule is there, 80-20. I will discuss. If he is created, then what is the language of God? Like, it was not a solo team, it must be a team. Just suppose if you are winning something, you are playing against any of the team in sports or anything, then you must have team. Like, God also must be have team. Like, if you are going Hindu philosophy, any of the philosophy, always we will discuss in the group of the God, means group of the person or group of the you can say divine person who has created. How they used to communicate among each other? What is the language of God? If we will understand this one, then only we will be able to understand further this one. This is your one religion, is their Taoism. This is, they have defined their philosophy, all or nothing. Everything or nothing. From nothing to everything, everything to nothing. This is only life. And this is given like this. If you are full happy, then also some point of sorrowness will be there. If you are a complete sorrowness, some point of time you will be happy. Or you can say few percentage of your personality will be happy. Due to, if we are too happy, that time also aansu aate. If we are in very difficult time, that time also aansu aate. This is the reason. Now this is our final universe, this shape. Then what is the language of God? Silence. Silence is the language of God. All else is poor translation. That silence only we are translating in different way or different philosophy or different scientific facts and logic, and we are defining all the subject and all the curriculum. But language of God is silence. Now we are coming to the little more nearer to our target. Universe is made of space and matter, and this space and matter, due to movement, it is creating time. Another challenging question. Maybe Einstein also tried to think, but he was unable to think. Before Big Bang, time itself was not there. Just try to think, what is time? Einstein has told, time is the fourth dimension. Three dimension we know. 1D, 2D, 3D we know. But fourth dimension is time. What, before Big Bang, time itself was not there. If time itself was not there, then how to measure when universe is created, when it has destroyed, and what is the cyclicity of that? It is again puzzling question. Again, answer will come, we don't know. But anyway, now I am coming little realistic picture where we can understand the thing. We are coming out from we don't know. We are coming in the zone of we know, whatever we know. Universe is 80% of space and 20% only matter. Whatever heavenly body we are seeing, like in the form of planets, stars, or any of the things, that is only 20%. 80% are blank space. Or you can say it is a nothing. This 80-20 rule, it is applicable universally. And if you don't know, this is one of the management principle also, 80-20. Anything we are doing, always 80-20 will be applied. Nothing to 100%, 100%, 80% space or nothing, 20% only converted to matter. I'm not going in deep, otherwise it will be very interesting philosophical point. Now, we are coming to the point, how to build good vocabulary. Now, once I will explain this point, then you will understand why I've discussed about the nothing, God, and these all. You will get one reference of the thinking. And that reference of thinking, it will be a chain. We will keep on go, and we will keep on forward, and we will able to build more than 1 lakh vocabulary. Not easily, but you can. In short span of time. In same number of vocabulary with good concept, it will take maybe lifelong. But you can build if you want, but for CAT that much is not needed. But if you want, 1.2 lakh vocabulary you can build in very short span of time. One of the ways there, reading broadly, exhaustively, and regularly. Or you can add if one point or SES reading. This of course, and this will be always helpful. But only problem will be there if you don't know the concept of the word generation or how to understand the vocabulary and this chain of the vocabulary. Then whatever you will get the word through reading, it may not useful during your required time. It will be random electron, or you can say free electron. It will keep on move here, there in your brain. It will not fit in any of the slot. Brain will work based on the connection. Put one nail in wall, you can hang multiple thing. But if nail is not there, you will not able to hang a single thing. And always, whenever you are learning anything, either vocab, math, or any knowledge, or any experience, either listening, or you are reading, or you are experiencing, or you are observing, through all four ways we are learning, then always you try to put in some slot, try to put in some nail. It will be lifelong. Recovery will be easy. Recalling will be easy. Then reading broadly, exhaustively, and regularly, it must be. But how to utilize all these learning for exam purpose, or you can say lifelong learning purpose. Then second method is there to understand the concept of word generation and how they are interrelated to each other. Only if again here problem will be there, many of the people will tell you have to understand the root of the word. Very good. But how root are interrelated to each other? What are the narrative behind the root? It is difficult. Difficult to express it, difficult to teach, which it is so vast. Everything is cyclic format. How to understand? Very good intellectual capacity needed to make it in a format of learning. Because word generation, again, root you will start to learn. Many of the root, thousands of root are there. You will forget root itself. Then what to do? How to memorize root? Again, you will start to mugging up. Now you are putting effort to mugging up the root itself. From one root, multiple words will come. How to mug up? Meanwhile, time will be swiftly cross. Exam will come. You can say, if I am wrong, based on huge experience I am telling. This is all a common thing. We will keep on do, and during meantime, swiftly our time will cross. And to understand this concept of word generation, we must have some narrative. We must have some interconnectivity, and we must have some conceptual and logical flow of understanding. For that sake only, I have given the background to understand about this universe, God. Now we came to certain conclusion. Just I will put in cyclic format. Why? Because everything from nothing to nothing, we don't know to we don't know. Then before God, then here God. God has created universe, and after God. These part only little known, from God to universe, little known. And from universe to after God, little known. After God again, we don't know. This part we don't know, 80% we don't know, 20% hardly we know. That is also not sure, not concluding. Means we can say we are just moving to and fro motion between we don't know, and that is giving a sense of cyclicity of time and creation. The reference point is we don't know. Reference point is not universe creation. Reference point is we don't know, because major time is nothing. 80% time, nothing. 20% time, only visibility. Then vocabulary, you can say it is a cyclically interrelated to each other. You just pick any of the vocabulary. Just I will tell you, if you want any of the thing, worship. If you will keep on move, you will come to one point. If you are starting with another vocabulary, just suppose any of the water, you will keep on move, water flow, water movement, after then water system, rivers, finally you will come to the same point. So what is there? Every vocabulary having their own cyclicity nature. Due to it is difficult to command. Although we are putting much effort to understand the root and these all, it is not working out. If I am telling wrong, you can tell me. It is not working out properly. Why? Because everything is cyclic in nature. And this cyclicity, if we will not break, it will not become a good learning management system. If you want to convert this in a good learning point, then we have to break this cyclicity. Only issue is there, from which point we have to break, and we have to make it linear, to make it a concept, you can say a logical conceptual way. Now, to understand this cyclicity must be break into a linear format, because our brain is easy understanding this one. Due to Western people are believing time is a linear. We are keep on moving towards something. Which thing? We don't know. But we are keep on moving. Indian philosophies are telling time is a cyclic in nature. Actually, everything is finally cyclic. But for understanding for a particular area, we must make it linear. Like if a big circle is there, if you will try to understand this big circle, it is difficult to understand. If same thing, you will cut at 2 points and make it a linear, then understanding will be easy. Then cut the thread at right point for conceptual interrelation and better narrative. Narrative must be there. A story must be there. How it is interrelated. Why we are interrelating all these words together. Then we have cut, I cut for conceptual clarity at nothing. Because our journey is from nothing to nothing. Then you can say overall, for language and vocabulary learning, these four major blocks you can say before God, God to universe, universe to beyond God. This is your universe and God. Here only maximum vocabulary will come. Before God, nothing. Before God, nothing. Beyond God, nothing. Then maximum vocabulary will come here. Now these two major building blocks, how to conceptualize? This is main challenge. How to conceptualize? Due to I created one different concept. The concept is framework. Because we cannot categorize in the form of type or you can say classification. No. Because they are not different in nature. All are vocabulary. Then I made 6 major framework. And these framework, 50 ideation point is there. Ideation means group of ideas. And through this 50 ideation, we will able to learn around 1200 idea unit. Always try to learn in idea unit. If you want to become a good speaker, you must work on idea unit. If you are working on an individual sentence, you will always problem. Idea unit. This is one idea. Related to this idea, these things are there. You make it to unit. And this every idea unit will be a cluster of word. Or you can say just a compilation of words. And through this 1200 idea unit, 150,000 or 1.5 lakh words you will able to learn each day. You want to learn further? That is, I am telling simple. 1.5 lakh based on this 1200 idea unit. Now how much easy to conceptualize? For CAT MBA anyway, 5k is enough. 5k whatever you have learned through this 1200 idea unit, that will be sufficient. Maybe it is not all 1200 idea unit. Maybe you have learned 600-700 idea unit, and based on that 600 idea unit, if you have just created your 5000 words, that will be sufficient. Actually, any language, if you want to speak, minimum 300 words are needed. If you want to speak French, you learn minimum 300 words. If you want to speak Kannada, learn 300 words, you will be able to speak. Minimum is 300 words. If you want to speak fluently, then 1000 words are needed. This is a common scientific figure. Beyond, if you are accumulating in use or in your reservoir, 5000 words, that will be enough for your tackling the exam. If beyond is coming, you have the tool. How to understand it. No need to mug up. Now, this was your second point, like how to build up a good vocabulary, this concept. Another thing you are keep on doing, reading, listening or observation. This you keep on do. Don't disturb this process because this is your input. You will get always need. Now, only thing you have to do, because here only we are doing mistake or we don't have or we don't know the correct process how to utilize these new words. Whatever new friend you met during the reading yesterday newspaper, that new friend how to tackle, how to deal with them. What you have to do, if you found a new or interesting or important word, then just follow reverse process. What we have done here, framework to ideation, ideation to idea unit to cluster of words, cluster word to the individual word. Just to follow reverse process. You just found one new words, you try to connect which idea unit it will be. Just it is a matter of practice. This idea unit is related to which ideation and this ideation is related to which framework. If every word, whatever you are facing new, if you start to do this process, everything you will able to classify in 6 major framework. And this 6 major framework has broken based on the, you can say, logic, not like a just anywhere or anyway, based on certain logic. This 6 major framework will give you always satisfaction and idea. Any word from anywhere you want to understand, I can. understanding and to keep in memory, it will be easy. Otherwise, it will be free electron. It will keep on move here, there it will be out. It will keep on run or keep on move in your brain after few days, out. How to attach? This is attachment process. This is nailing process. We have the nails. Six nails are there. Six major nails. In there, every nail, some ideations are there. You just imagine like that in your brain, like any laptop folder, six subfolder, every folder. Again, ideation to idea unit, idea unit words. If you are getting new friends in the form of new vocabulary, just follow reverse process. That word you try to immediately guess, which idea unit? This idea unit related to which ideation? This ideation related to which framework? Yes, any words you will able to pick these six framework. It will not go out like a free electron. It will be helpful whenever you want. It is not like a depends on their wish. It will depends on your wish when you want to use them. And this is a just process you have to apply. Now, just I will give you an example, because in one workshop I cannot explain all six framework. It will be very it is a time consuming process. Who are a CAT 21 premium student during your vocab session, all six framework I will try to conceptualize and I will try to explain. But that much is not needed for your CAT preparation, due to I will not go in that much lengthy process. But what is needed, I will give you full detail and full list of ideation, idea unit and how to understand it. Framework 1, name is God, Space and Time, due to I given you the all background, because everything is starting from nothing. Here 5 ideations are there and almost 100 idea unit will be there in framework 1. How much clarity you are getting? Just to think and you just rewind your time, maybe last 10 years or 15 years, any point of time, did you got this type of conceptual clarity about the vocab built up? I think no. Ideation 1, just I will discuss now. This out of 5 ideation, first ideation is before God and universe. Now, our focus is these 3 building blocks. This will flow in your, you can say whatever natural flow is there. Just you think, before God, universe, after universe, our solar system, after solar system, this earth, after earth, atmosphere on the earth surface and below the earth surface. On the earth surface, what are the creatures? We will learn about that. Below the earth surface, what are the things? About the minerals, about the water, about the lava, whatever is there, we will learn about that. Once we are coming to our all these things, most important is human being, person, man. We'll focus on that. 2 framework will be dedicated about the man, their biology, their thinking, their afterwards socialization, everything. And afterwards, man will start to become thinking wise, very mature, and they will start to get the wisdom. But after wisdom, again, no point of thinking, we don't know. Then we will start with nothing, we'll again end with nothing. And this will be whole process of vocabulary building. Then before God, universe. Now these 3 idea unit, just will try to understand. This is your before God. What was before God? Nothing. Nothing has come from a root thinga, that is from Proto-Germanic. No need to worry what is Proto-Germanic, what is Indo-European. I will give you the clear cut idea, not today. In premium classes it is there, but some other workshop I will give you the idea how language has emerged, because now it will become a much, if I will give you, it will take much time. Then here thinga root, thinga is a root, it is coming from Proto-Germanic. No thinga, no thinga means, meaning is assembly. Thinga means assembly. If no person in assembly, this is called no thinga. Actually, it was a countable noun only, but now we are using in uncountable format also. Do you have some milk? Nothing. Milk is a uncountable noun. Means now nothing is used for countable noun also, uncountable noun. Just to think what we can make related to this. Nothing means no one, none, not anything, not something, null. All words are related. But you are very clear all these words are related to ideation, and that ideation is before God and universe, and that is related to your first framework, that is God, space and time. Related to nothing, we can make multiple, you can say, format of learning, like do nothing, know nothing, nothingness, nothingarian, amounting to nothing, zero, cipher, not, nil, out. All are related to nothing. What you are learning now? Before God. Before God, what was there? Nothing was there. Now, tools for vocabulary. I will explain a little bit more. What tools we are using here? Origin. It is very beautiful, beautiful story. I don't have that much time, but very beautiful story are there. Every word, how it is originated. Then after origin, root word, prefix, suffix, context of use. That is, you have to work out that. Because all these things are almost fixed. Root, prefix, suffix. But context of use are variable. You can just make it is a mathematics. It is a constant. It is a variable. And variable, you must be careful. You must work out. It may be figurative use. It may be direct use. It may be in the form of figure of a speech. It may be in the form of, you can say, many of the things, maybe it will be. Context of use, it will be very vast. Pronunciation, again, this is almost fixed, but you can say, depends on the region and usage, and you can say geography, it will be little change. Everything is acceptable. Like Indian accent are acceptable worldwide. Similar way, if you are going to the like a French people or Spanish people, their accent often is also acceptable. Then pronunciation, you can say little subjective. Most of the concept are fixed, but many have to work out on the context of usage. Origin, it is all origin. You can say a story type. If you are learning in a story way or you are listening, it will be interesting. But you can say examination point of view, it is not much helpful. But we know, we should understand, or we should know about this story, because it will be a good narrative to memorize it. Root of the words, again, how prefix and suffix will change it, the meaning of the root, that also we should know. We'll discuss it. Now I'm coming to your next idea unit, that is, before God nothing was there. From nothing, not much word will be there. We almost gather 20 words related to nothing. Now we'll come to the next idea unit, that is your God. Now, first thing is coming in your mind, God. Then what we are thinking? God is sacred. Just natural way. Don't apply any bookish knowledge. What we are thinking? God is sacred. God is holy. God is worshipped. Pray to God. If you are doing the pray, you will do the devotion. If you are doing the devotion, then you may be loyal or may be disloyal. God is having supernatural power. God is created based on the some fact, or mostly mythological creatures like Jupiter, Titan. These all are Greek gods. It's a mythology. Where gods are living? Imaginative points, heaven. Imaginative or real, we don't know. Actually, we don't know. Just opposite of God, devil. Devil are doing magic, black magic, necromancy, sacrosanctity. Where they are living? In hell. Heaven, hell. How much concept, you can say logical flow, you understand. Now this simple logical flow, we will able to gather more than 100 words. And all 100 words will be attached with one small tiny points, that is God. If we understand in this way of conceptual flow or diagram, if we create a good narrative or a story to understand, like just suppose this full block, if we are creating a one narrative or one story, how much it will be enjoyable process to build up your vocabulary. Very enjoyable process. You will never lost your interest. Now I am just explaining God. I don't know how to explain. We don't know nothing about God. God is coming Greek root words of theos. Now God is, you can say, worshipped, or God, you can say, believe in different format at different part of world. Parallel words. This is parallel words. You can say God parallel words. You can say supreme deity, almighty, the all powerful, Brahma also an English word acceptable. The creator, the Lord, omnipotent, the spirit, Titan, Jupiter, Siren, Zeus, all are a parallel word to God. God is sacred. Another point we got, Latin root of sacer means holy. I think this you will never forget. God is sacred, God is worshipped. No, God is worship. Worship is nothing. It is made by two words, worth and sip. if any ship actually meaning was there, if it is coming towards your port, if it is a, it is, you can say, full of the important important articles or important things, then we could say it is a worship. That is shortcut, is a worship. That is God we are doing worshiping. That is a ritual, or you can say glorify, idealize, all our worshiping process. I have just discussed few. We'll just start to connect. Only thing we should know where to cut it, because once you will keep on move, then again you will come to the same point. Again you will, then again it will be confusion. Circularity we will not do here. We'll just move 3-4 points like this way. God, God is sacred, holy, worshipped, God, devotion. Again, loyal. Loyal will come here, so many meaning. Loyalty is not towards God only. Loyalty is coming toward many of the things. Then if you will further make the chain, then it will be confusing. Then only 3-4 step you make, close it. 3-4 step you make, close it. Then it will be a conceptual idea unit. Now just suppose, if you know the theos, now understanding and memorizing all these words will be easy. Theist, atheist, theology, theocracy, pantheon, apothesis, thearchy, theocentric, theocrat, theodicy, agnosticism, monotheism, bitheism, polytheism, theopantheism. Multiple words. This is only related to this root. If you will come to the parallel words of God, again we will able to create, like if you are coming to the Almighty, then Almighty again having the different root, based on that we will, due to we should not create here chain reaction, then what will happen, you will get confusion. Where to cut this chain, we must know to learn in this way, this linear way. Automatically everything will be covered in systematic way. That much word. Now we'll come to the sacred, sacre. How many words are there? Sanctuary, this is a word from coming from sacre. Sacrosanct, consecration, desecration, sacrilege, execrate, sanctify, sanctum, sanction. All these words are coming. Meaning is holy. Now I think I have discussed much. Now we'll come to the next, because further if discussion we'll do in another workshop. How to make this all ideation point in a further conceptual use, or you can say how to make a group of words, or you can say compilation of words from any idea unit. Then next we'll do the impromptu speaking. Impromptu speaking, this rule we know, like I think today how many people are there? Okay, Tanishk and Sumit is there. Speak 2 to 3 minutes, try to use small and simple sentences, present simple, past simple, future simple, present perfect tense, use more. Quotations, slokes, poems, if you know, it will increase your value. Try to use sequence and chronology. Then out of Sumit and Tanishk, who will speak first? Sumit, you want to speak, or Tanishk, you want to speak?
Sir, I'll do it second.
Okay. Sumit?
Hello. Yes, sir.
Yes, Sumit. You can speak.
Yes, sir.
And how was last 40-45 minutes? You understand something about the vocabulary?
Little, sir.
One season you can't understand full, but this concept you understand, how to read the vocabulary and how to how to build a good vocabulary. This is a conceptual idea, because once you will not able to correlate with any particular point, or if you are not able to connect with a concept or connect with a nail, then it will not, you will not able to recall at proper time. That is only issue. Then just in same way we will flow, and in same concept your video will be there in your premium course, and all 6 framework will be explained, and afterwards you will feel like aha, this may be happen, and you will able to make 5000 6000 vocabulary very easy. But you have to repeat the video one time, maybe all will not, you will able to memorize, maybe one or two video you have to repeat. Okay Sumit, these are all the topics: Cabinet of India, role of President of India, Cabinet Minister versus State Minister, Tricolor of India, $5 trillion of Indian economy. Next topic is import versus export. Next is your SSI. Next is your 7 sisters of Indian Union. And next is your river system of system of India. And next is your poverty is a state of mind, and climate change. And further topic is Facebook and society. Facebook is killing the social relation, or it is increasing the social relation. Favorite book, Last Dream, How to Start a Blog, Social Media Management or Marketing, Social Media Marketing, Introverts or Extroverts, any topic you can pick.
Yes, sir, last page.
Which one? Last dream. Dream will be never last. Yes, Sumit, which topic? Not decided.
Last dream, sir.
Introverts or extrovert?
Last dream. Yes, sir.
Oh, last dream. Okay. Yes. Good. You can take 30 seconds. I will tell you to start.
Okay, sir. Start.
Yeah, you can start it.
There are many dreams in my mind. But main dreams is I will go to IIM college. But how to fill this dream? Because I am belong to small cities, not developed society. But my dream is always big. So I am trying to fulfill my dream that I will go to IIM college. Dream is not sleeping dreams. Dream is always how to feel.
Continue.
Sir, mind mein aayi nahi raha, sir.
Okay. Okay, no issue. We'll close it, huh?
Okay, sir.
Okay. Achha, one thing, Sumit. What is the topic? Last dream. It was not about the main dream.
Oh.
First mistake here.
Yes.
Second, you can take example. APJ Abdul Kalam. Kalam was from also a very small city. Most of the successful people in India who has done something great, they are from a village or maybe a small town.
Yes, sir.
Because all big city people, they are oversatisfied. I'm not telling all. But I'm telling many of the peculiar achievement is done from a small town or a small city person. Due to this logic, I am coming from a small city. It cannot be possible. You remove from your mind. This is not any blockage or this is not barricade in your achievement. Okay? Any
yes.
person can do. I already told you conscious brain and subconscious brain. How to use subconscious brain? Multiple times I explained to you. Try to use it. Everything is our thinking only. Nothing is outside. Whatever we are thinking, that way only we will transform. Correct, na?
Yes.
Then that I am just telling you, don't think like I cannot do. You can do it. This is not a big thing. You will go to the IIM college. Many of the people you will find their background is small villages. Small villages, not city or town also. They are coming. And even once you are going to the IIM, like second round test, and they also know this is India. Hardly 2-3% people are staying in metropolitan city. Remaining are in B-level town or you can say C-level town. Correct? Small
yes,
city
yes.
or maybe town level. They have to select from where they will bring the people from France or different country. No, they have to select from Indian people only. Then this is not a... You can say any of the barrier you remove from here. Now coming to the point, topic was last dream. It was not main dream. Then how you have to start, like recently, whatever most recent dream you have seen, either maybe your open eye or maybe during the sleeping. About that you have to explain. First criteria during speaking and writing or during RC reading, always stick to the point. If you are coming out of that, it will be problematic. Last dream is maybe yesterday or day before yesterday or maybe few days before. Whatever you have seen in your dream, that you have to explain. Okay? And try to make sentence, small sentence, little fast. That much gap no need to take because it is only 2-3 minutes speaking. Correct? If you will take much longer pause, then it will be difficult to put your point. Or to just you can say put your logic. Small sentence, close. Again start. You can just start. Last dream I have seen 3 days before, or maybe whatever reality, or you can take some not actual point or some you can say virtual point also, or some fake point also. The 3 days before I have seen the last dream, that dream I was seeing this. After the dream, what happened? You wake up or something happened. These 3-4 lines. That dream is coming in my mind very regularly. Why it is coming? Because I want to relate it to this. Over. 6 to 7 sentence sufficient to explain, correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay, Sumit. You are doing the practice, solo practice? No.
Yes,
after after phase one, we'll start the group practice also. Whatever your group is there now, this CAT 21 premium group, we'll start this discussion. But meanwhile, you can do the solo practice in front of mirror, you can do, or in front of your best friend who knows you very well, or whom you are having the confidence he cannot make the negative comment, because maybe people will be afraid from negative comment. But you must start this practice. Mirror is best. You just come in front of mirror. Take any topic. Only follow these 2-3 principles. Time constant. Otherwise, you purchase this stop badge. And afterwards, you have to use simple sentence. You have to use this present simple and past simple and present perfect. These all tense you have to use. Try to use maximum active voice. Wherever it is not possible to use active voice, then we have to use passive voice. Okay. But you start this practice, Sumit. It will be much, much helpful. Very much helpful. Okay. Okay, done. Yes, Tanishq.
Yes, sir.
Yep. Are you going to pick any of the topic from this page? Otherwise, I will scroll it up.
Can I take Facebook and society, sir? Can you explain me a little about the heading? I didn't understand.
Facebook and society means after Facebook means you can
say, how it affected the society. Do I have to speak?
Correct.
Okay.
Positive and negative both aspect you can keep.
Okay, sir. I'll start.
Yeah, you can start it now, sir.
So, most of us, everyone knows, like, Facebook was found by Mark Zuckerberg. Facebook has both positives and negatives on how it is affecting society. Recent surveys show that, like, when you're constantly being updated with your friends' news, it has led to decrease in traditional communication methods, like meeting people, although in this pandemic it's not possible. But there have been a decreasing number of traditional communication methods, like speaking in person, or like the very old telephonic conversations. And coming to the positives, like, we can share all of our updates, whatever we want, on Facebook. It, not only Facebook, all social media platforms. People say that Facebook has been causing a lot of social problems and has negative psychological effects, because they include feelings of jealousy and stress. When someone else is posting about their life, you tend to get a little bit of social media addiction, and which causes to it could be an addiction, social media addiction. So, like, there are some negative and social problems that Facebook has to deal with. Apart from this, we can speak to anybody over the world with just a click or an immediate texting. So, an average person has basically increased the his amount of time spending on social media, like over the screens, by constantly checking for updates on his friend's social life and his influencers. If I have to say if social media was a positive boon to a society, I'm not very sure. But because I tend to stay as far as possible from social media, because I feel it's usually pretty much getting you addicted these days. And with the latest Instagram Reels that has been released, most of the youth are spending their very, very important time on these Instagram and other reels, so which has to be reduced. Yes, sir, that's all. I kept going.
No. Good. Anyway, you have highlighted all the dimensions. That is a good point. Only thing is there, like, it should be a little more factful. Otherwise, it was good. Highlighting wise, like what can be dimension, like you started with the Facebook owner and afterwards you came to that it is a new communication tool which can be used easily by any of the person in at any location. This is, you can say, advantage only. This is not disadvantage. If we are becoming addiction of that, that is our problem. It is not Facebook problem. If we know wasting the time unnecessary, it is a not good for life. Still we are wasting time, then Facebook can't stop. If it is a becoming addiction, then it is a negative. But otherwise, in just 1 second, you can update your thousand of friends, relatives, immediately what you are doing or what has happened with you. Maybe sometimes positive news, sometimes negative news. Otherwise, maybe you have 200, 300 people in your circle or your relatives' friend. Calling everybody, it is not easy always. Always we don't have that much time. Then many of the dimension, it is good. And your speaking also, it was good. It is highlighted almost all area for impromptu speaking, because it is not a lecture type of speaking or you have to speak 10 or 15 minutes. It is not a group discussion or it is not a individual speaking. It is impromptu speaking, 2 to 3 minutes, that much highlight is enough. Only little more factful. Here, we can give one or two example about the positive and negative. Whatever real example is there, then it must be helpful. Otherwise, it is fine. Good. Then we'll just move onward. I think last point hour is there, just about the information about the CAT 21 premium. This is your Google. You just type it paroliko.paroliko. You will get this website address and your Google map address. You can just click on your courses. You will get competitive courses. You just click, you will get the CAT 21 premium. And here CAT 21 premium, you can purchase the full course. That is better because still discount is going on. And afterwards, you can say individual courses if you want, that also you can. How to use this? Very simple process. Login, you can do your username and password. You will log in. Or if you have not registered, just go to the register page, hardly 2 or 3 information you have to put, you will get registered. And after registration, you will get your login ID password, then it will be easy to log in or it will be easy to get the updates also. And once you have become your premium student, you will get badge here, premium student, and all the courses will be listed down here. I have also almost same, you can say system will be there. From homepage, you will come like this one. This is your sign in. Or if you have not signed in, you can sign up or you can register. Or afterwards, you will able to see all the YouTube embedded link related to any topic. Like if it is related to quant, then you will get so many, like more than 10 YouTube link where you can click and you can take the idea about the different type of topic, how it is discussed in YouTube videos. And afterwards, all the listing will be done based on the, you can say, classification of the courses, like section, then block, then folder, then individual video. And afterwards, thank you very much. Good night. One more session we'll plan related to vocabulary. I think it will be helpful. Good night. Good night, Sumit. Good night, Tanishq. Bye-bye.
Good night, sir. Thank you. Thanks for the seminar.